In this video, we're going to take a look at the transformation effect in stylism by Astute Graphics. First, I just want to draw out some basic artwork here on my artboard, and then we're going to come over here to the stylism panel and then add this transformation effect. All I have to do is click on it once, and you see it's been added to my artwork. If we look at the appearance panel, you see here I have this transformation effect added to the stack. So just keep in mind, this is the native live effect that ships with Adobe Illustrator. I'll hit cancel to get out of here. And next, let's take a look at this interface we have going on here. So here we have four big annotations right next to the artwork. And let's see what's going on here. So if you look at over here in the 9 o'clock location, we have this reference point. Now this is referring to where the transformation is going to be coming from. So right now I have it set to center, and I'll show you what that does a little bit later. And right here in this top location, this is where you're able to toggle on and off the ability to scale your strokes and effects. Over here in this 3 o'clock location, this is where we could add more copies or remove some of the copies we've added. And then down here at the 6 o'clock location, you have the ability to randomize your effect, but by default, it's set to non-random. All right, so let's take a look at what this guy's all about. So I have my artwork set up here, and when I'm hovering over this artwork, you see this annotation letting me know that the offset is at 0 pixels by 0 pixels. So to create an offset, all I have to do is click and drag, and when I release, you see it's actually moved the appearance over here. So if we look at it in outline mode, you see my original artwork is still here, but the appearance has moved over here with this offset. Now, while I have it over here, I'm going to hover over this corner annotation. This is showing me the horizontal and vertical scale values. So if I click and drag on this, it allows me to scale my effect. So as you can see here, I'm doing a free scale, and if I hold down the shift key, it'll actually constrain my proportions for me. Now we can introduce the command key, and it'll slow down this annotation for a more precise edit. All right, when I release, you see it's been updated here on my artboard. Next, you also see these dotted lines here connecting to the corners of my artwork. That's kind of just a reference point so you have an idea of where you are with your rotations. So if I hover over this annotation here and then just go out a little bit further, I get these two little arrows pointed up, which is a rotation annotation. You can see here it's set to 0 degree. If I want to make changes here, I just click and drag, and you see this dotted line is updating, and as I go all the way around, it continues to just give me an idea of how much of a rotation I'm actually creating. I also have the annotation that is constantly updating, so I know exactly where I am on the artboard. Alright, so I'll release right here, and you see it's completely updated. Now, these were all freeform transformations that we've been doing, but if you look here, the annotation showing the offset, I can double click in this location, and I have this panel. Right here in this panel, I could add a specific X or Y offset, or if I come over here, I could just put in a specific distance, and you see all this information gets updated for me. So I'll click OK, and you see the change take place here. I can double click on this annotation, and I could set the horizontal and vertical scales. I could get the same panel by double clicking on this edge. I'll hit cancel, and I could just reposition it really easy by just clicking and dragging and moving it around. All right, now I'm gonna just scale this guy down a bit, and see, we have a little bit of a rotation going on here. Now we could add some more copies here by just clicking right here on this button, and you see it's starting to create new copies for me here on my artboard. If you wanted to reduce the number of copies, just click on this button down here, and you see we're bringing it all the way back up here. Now when I was hovering over my artwork, it shows me the offset for the actual appearance. If I come over here to this annotation, now you see it changes to show me how many copies I have. So while I have this reading here, I could click and drag on this annotation, and you see I'm freely creating these new copies. Now that I have all these copies here, I want to show you this reference point section. Right now it's set to the center, but you see if I click over here to one of these edges, it's actually changing the reference point for the transformations. There you go, I'm going to leave it set to the center. Down here, you see this is set to non-random. When I click on it, it gives you the random effect, which is the same effect you have right here in your transformation panel. When I click preview here and then click random, you see you have the exact same behavior. I'll cancel to get out of that. Now, I have some scaling going on with my artwork, but as you can see, the stroke has kept the same stroke weight across all the way down to the bottom. If I want to change that behavior, come here to the top, click on this once, and now you see my stroke has been scaled all along the bottom there. All right, great. Now, if you want to make changes to this, keep in mind, this guy that's highlighted, this is the one you want to make changes to. So click and drag on it, and that's how you're able to start rotating this guy around. So now that I have this guy repositioned, my little lizard tail, this is more of an artistic way of using it. Now I'm going to show you a more practical way. Let's come back over here to the stylism panel. Now I already have a transformation effect added here, and I want to start from scratch again. I can click on this effect and it removes it, and I'll click on it again, and what it does is it reinstates the default transformation. So there's actually no transformation added to it, but we do have it here at the bottom of the stack. Great, so the more practical use for it is just clicking on this offset and bringing it off to the side. Now, you see I'm not constraining it, so I have to hold down the shift key, and that will constrain it for me. So I just want to bring this out to about, 130 pixels. So I could either click and drag to move it around this like this, or hold down the command key for more precise edits. And that's going to help me get right in there to 130. But see, it's kind of dancing around still a little bit. I could actually get it, but instead of having to dance around like that, you could double click in here and just enter it manually. I'll click OK, and now I know I have 130 pixels separation here. Great, so now I want to lay this out as a grid, so I'll click and drag, and now I have it laid out going this direction, and now it's time to pile on these effects. So come over here to the stylism panel, and I want to add another instance of this transformation effect. So I'll hold down the shift key and click on it again, and you see it's been added here to the appearance panel. Here in the stylism panel, this transformation effect is targeted. I'll click on the drop down menu and you see this other transformation was added to the bottom of the stack. I want to now target this new transformation, and you see my annotations are all reset. So let's come over here and click and drag to create this offset. Now remember, hold down the shift key and that will keep it constrained for you. And when I release, you see it updated here. Well, I want to double click on it and make sure I set this offset to 130 pixels like we did in the other one. There you go. So now it'll match up. But we actually haven't created any copies yet. All we've done was move our original set of artwork. So I'm just going to click and drag here. We created one new copy, and that's going to add this guy here. Now click and drag and create as many more copies as I need. This technique really comes in handy for different types of print layout. I've used it for creating stickers or even promotional buttons for bands. And that's how you use the transform effect in Stylism by Astute Graphics.